Hello and welcome to our guide on how to prepare TimeTech subtitles for Netflix. To illustrate, we'll use a short sample file in SRT format running alongside a short video. We'll cover setting up the project settings, going through the quality control checking, automatic fixes, and how to export the subtitles into a TimeText file. So the first step will be to start a new project. Here we have to make sure all parameters are set in accordance with the current edition of the Netflix style guide. For this demo, we're using the version of the style guide from 27th of July 2020, so it might be a good idea to comply with the most recent edition of the documentation first. Now, let's start Easy Titles and open Project Settings from the File menu. We need to select Open DVD for Project Type, Native for Mode, None HD NLE for Authoring System, and All Netflix Glyphs for Charset. Make sure to select the video format frame rate and timecode standard options according to your material. We use a video in Full HD resolution running at 23.976 frames per second. Please note that when the video is running at this frame rate, 24 frames per second timecode format must be selected. Now we should move to the Save Area page, where we can set the maximum number of characters for each one of the text lines in the subtitle file. Please note that this option may differ for each individual language, so make sure to check with the style guide first. In this example, we are preparing subtitles in English, so we enter 42. You can leave all of the remaining options to their default values. From the Fonts menu, we can change the font and the size of the subtitles. Please bear in mind that the choices we make here depend on the requirements for the specific language in the style guide. For subtitles in English, the font must be Arial, and the chosen size shall allow 42 characters to be entered into the text line. Therefore, for project in Full HD resolution, the font size shall not exceed 52 pixels. All other options may be left to their defaults. If you're working on subtitles in Arabic or Hebrew, you should also switch the right-to-left option on. From the subtitles page, you can select what the default attributes for your subtitles will be. Make sure they will be centered, as this is the default text position according to the style guide, and also that the auto-center left alignment and zero subtitle are switched off. The input language option is related to the spell checking, so you can set it to English in this case. You can select outline as effect, but it will serve only for previewing subtitles in Easy Titles, as the Netflix time text format currently doesn't support it. You can't use the box effect, as it's not allowed by the style guide, so you should leave it switched off unless instructed otherwise. Next, you have to choose the default color for the subtitles. Go to Effects and set the text color option to white. All other settings are not important. The Reading Speed menu speaks for itself. You set the desired reading speed for the subtitles. It can be measured as both words per minute and characters per second. The values you should put here depend on the specific requirements for each language and target audience. In this case, we enter 20 characters per second. We should also activate both count spaces and count punctuation options as per Netflix requirements. We recommend using character count as the representation option is and also setting the upper limits for both the indicator in the editor and the checks to 100%. To ensure that there are no subtitles exceeding the specified reading speed. Finally, you need to verify the contents of the cues page. Here you should find the minimum interval between subtitles, the maximum and minimum duration of the subtitles, and the parameters for subtitles snapped to a short change. According to the style guide, the minimum interval should be 2 frames. Configuring the minimum and maximum duration parameters is a bit trickier. The style guide gives them in seconds, while in Easy Titles they're measured in frames. The minimum duration should be 5/6 of a second per subtitle event, and the maximum duration should be 7 seconds per subtitle event. In our case, as we've selected 24 frames per second in project settings, the minimum duration equals 20 frames. The maximum duration should be set to 168 frames. However, calculating from seconds to frames is quite easy in fact. You should just use the frames per second timecode you've selected for your project and multiply it by 5/6 or 7 to see the required numbers of frames. Regarding the subtitle snap to a short change, you need to follow Netflix rules. In this case, continuous dialogue should begin on the shot change and end 2 frames before the next shot change. So we need to set before cut interval to 2 frames and after cut to 0 frames. You should also activate the snap to shot change on set cue and set threshold to 11 and gap to 0 frames. In this way, when you insert in or out cues less than 12 frames away from the shot changes, they will be automatically snapped according to before cut and after cut values. You don't need to activate the last two options. And that concludes the project settings. You could even save a project setting template so you don't have to go through all these settings next time. To do this, click on the new button there, enter your desired name for the new template, and press OK to save it. Next time, you just have to select the name from the list and press OK. Now you should load the sample SRT file into Easy Titles. To do this, go to that button and select your file from its location. It's important to select the proper code page. In our case, that's the correct one. For this video, we won't be showing you how to prepare subtitles from scratch. For that, you should refer to our user guide or visit our YouTube channel. Then you should load the video file as well. Go to Video, Open Video File menu, select the file and click Open. A window pops up where you need to select the video start timecode. You should always consider the SMPTE timecode which appear in that picture. The timecode in Easy Titles should match the SMPTE one and not the media time. Our next step will be to perform a couple of quality control checks on the subtitles and make sure the file meets all requirements of the Netflix style guide. We recommend to run a couple of checks before you export your file. To perform a quality control check, go to Titles, check Subtitles, and select the required criteria. Since you're working for Netflix, you may want to check for several things. If there are any subtitles with inconsistent cues, for subtitles that might be longer or shorter than the minimum maximum duration, for subtitles that might appear above or below the selected reading speed, if the gap between the subtitles is less than 12 frames, if there are any non-printable characters, and if any subtitles contain more than 2 text lines. When it comes to shot changes, you should check if the created subtitles follow the rules for snapping set in the cues menu in project settings. To be even more confident in the quality of your subtitles, you could use the attribute section and verify all subtitles are white in color and they are aligned to the center of the screen. If any subtitles need to be fixed, you could navigate through the list by using the previous and next buttons. We can see that this subtitle's text duration is shorter than the minimum allowed by the reading speed, so you can fix it by manually dragging the out cue on the timeline. Pressing the log button will create a log list with all of them for you to review. After running the checks, you have a good idea if any of the subtitles don't comply with the style guide. Instead of modifying them by hand, you can use the Titles Fix Subtitles feature. Select the range of the subtitles for which the options will be applied. You can choose from plenty of options such as all subtitles, those in the log, or draft list, etc. We're going to fix the subtitles in the log list as we already know they have been identified to have some issues. So we're going to fix the subtitles below or above the reading speed, fix the intervals, and fix the subtitles below or above the minimum or maximum duration. In the shot changes menu, you could also fix the subtitles distance from the shot changes according to the Netflix rules. Just select the Netflix mode option and Easy Titles will fix the cues around shot changes as well as possible. Now you need to press the OK button and see the results of your fixes. Please mind that sometimes it might not be possible for Easy Titles to automatically adjust all subtitles. That's why we always recommend running another check and eventually fixing these subtitles by hand. For both the check subtitles and fix subtitles, you can save the activated options as presets for later use. Subtitles reported as not center aligned or in different color can easily be formatted back to the preferred style by using the Titles Format options. As all subtitles for Netflix must be positioned to the center and contain only white text, it would be better to change the alignment and the color for all subtitles. Once you're sure the subtitles are ready and there are no issues with them, you can export your Netflix Time text file. For that, go to Export and select Netflix Time text option from the list. Press the Export button and the related Netflix Time text export options dialog will pop up asking you to specify just a few more things. Make sure to select the correct language from the drop-down menu. Otherwise, Netflix automatic quality control system will reject the file. Usually all delivered subtitles must start from zero. If you need to recut them, you can do that here by entering the start timecode of your video in the Media Start timecode field. If you have already recut your subtitles, or they don't need that, please enter zero to prevent any modifications of the timing in the output file. Selecting the correct time base is also very important. You can determine whether to use the Media Time or SMPTE timecode by checking with the Netflix guide on the subject. In this case, we'll use the SMPTE timecode. All other options can be left to the default values or to be modified to your own preferences and requirements. We recommend not to leave the title field empty. At the end, press the OK button to save your file. And this wraps up the Netflix Time Text export. Thank you very much for watching and enjoy your subtitling with Easy Titles.